Brian McFetta. How are you doing? Good to see you.
Hiya.
Look at that.
Oh, too keen. Oh.
You love it.
Oh, love it.
How does that make you feel?
Oh, it's very nice, you know. I mean, it's nice that my family could make it.
Yeah, the extended family, that. Exactly. We won't be passing around the aforementioned smoked sausage suppers, which I lived on when I was a student mate. And I have to say, that was the time for me when Popped In Sold Out was rocking the charts.
But you know how that chip shop cuisine in general,
yeah.
You know, it's the cornerstone of every nutritional diet. But up in Glasgow, they have that deep-fried Mars bar thing, don't
yeah.
they? Which is, I must admit, I haven't tried it myself, but they assure me it's meant to be quite delicious.
There is absolutely nothing that you cannot get deep fried when you're in Glasgow, as you well know.
It's frightening. Even the pizzas are deep fried.
Yeah, they are indeed. And they're gorgeous, aren't they? But you can only ever eat them up in Glasgow, as you'll know, because, you know, when you're ricocheting from bar to bar and you've had a few bevvies, I know you're clean and sober now, mate, but I'm still knocking back the sauce. Yeah. And it sobers you up immediately, the cold, doesn't it? You need something to soak up
and give you that resistance that you can snowball on.
Absolutely. Well, you are snowballing on and then some, mate. You look absolutely terrific. It's good to have you here.
Thank you very much for having me.
I want to take a quick butcher's, actually, single. You're going to want to dive into this video, ladies and gentlemen, if you've not seen it before. This is your new single. What's it called?
It's called Lot of Love.
Oh, that one. Let's take a butcher's.
Lot of Love.
I did warn you that it was a video that you would want to dive into, whether you're animal, vegetable, mineral, or whether you just want to dip in the sea. That was fantastic.
Come on, on board, Ashley.
Absolutely. Are we invited? Where was it shot?
It was shot in Cairns, just out, Cairns. Well, in a friend's mansion block that he's got there. You know, I'm trying to make myself sound more exotic than I am, really.
It's exotic enough for me.
You know, and we went there and we hung out for the day and, you know, we did some filming and generally ate too much. But you have to watch there because it was a roasting hot day.
Yeah.
And in between takes, I was just sitting in the sun thinking, like, you know, I'll top up my tan. But little did I know, I ended up with a nose that looked like a Belisha beaten. You know, it was like all swollen up. Action!
Like Miley. I mean, you try and be glamorous, don't you? But then you betray your roots. Especially, it's well documented your rise from the Dole queue to, you know, superstardom. And then, of course, a few issues, as we've talked about,
with
drugs and alcohol and stuff. Mm-hmm. But as I say, you're looking as fit as a fiddle now.
I am. I'm doing well for myself. I'm looking after myself and having an occasional sweetie.
Just the odd little sweet, the odd sour plum, if you like.
They're actually none too shabby.
They're not too bad.
Just as well, they aren't props, and I just swallowed about a half glass of them. But you know what? I would have just soldiered on.
They've been there a while. Even the cheeky girls have had their lips around those. What's that? I saw you in Chicago, and I have to say, it was absolutely fantastic. That was your choice to go into that, wasn't it?
Yeah,
Billy Flynn.
Yeah, they offered me the role of Billy Flynn, and I was really ignorant to the musicals. I hadn't seen. Bad idea with the
Bad idea, cheering on the box, isn't it?
Bear with me.
How are your dentures, mate?
Right,
because we're all of 37 now. Is that what we're owning up to?
All my own.
They're all your own.
And they said to me, would I like to come and be involved in it? And I saw the actual play and the musical and I fell in love with it. I thought it was great. I thought it was something I could bring to the table and I really, really embraced the whole challenge of it.
How long did you play it for?
I played it for 6 months and I've gone back to Broadway. And, you know, it's been absolutely phenomenal, the response I got from it. Because it could have went both ways, you know.
Yeah.
It could have went really bad for me. But, you know, I had a great support system and a great access to wonderful people who pointed me in the right direction.
And
that's only good news.
Well, a great support system seems to be the sort of theme of your life, because obviously Eileen you've been with for how many years now?
Yeah, but me and Eileen have been together now for
about 13 years.
Yeah, about 13, 14 years.
And she's got that rock on her finger, but no
well,
schlep up the aisle.
Well, I get asked that question on a daily basis, you know, but certainly not from Eileen anyway, thank heavens. But we're very much together and we're very much, you know, we're a couple and all that brings to the table.
Well, good on you, mate. Now, I know we've got a lovely a selection of a bevy of beauties, if you like, big fella, who want to ask you a few questions. Hello, as well. So it's not all about me. I want to get to these chaps because I know some of you have come a long way today. And we got some Leslie from Buckinghamshire. Is she there? Hiya, Leslie. Welcome to Loose Lips. Question for Marti, love.
Hi, Marti.
Hello, Leslie. How are you today?
Just wondering. I'm fine, thanks.
Oh, that's good.
Just wondering what kind of music you're listening to yourself at the moment.
Well, at the moment, I'm listening to a lot of Cole Porter. You know, just kind of old school. You know, I think that whole big band movement is, for me, it's fantastic. I love Nelson Riddle arrangements. So I've been kind of bathing in that quite a lot at the moment. I just think that those songs are not only from the past, but they're more relevant today and for the future. And that's the beauty of music like that. It has longevity. Good question. What are you listening to?
You?
Oh, you're listening to my new stuff? Oh, come have a sweetie.
You're talking about longevity. You've been around about 16 years as well,
I know.
Sir.
Yeah, yeah. I know.
Looking well on it, as I say. Mandy from Hertfordshire.
Hi, Marti.
Oh, Mandy.
Carry up, please.
There's
carry
a couple
of resist that man.
My ambition. Have you got any ambitions to achieve, dear?
You know, when I got involved in going into musical theatre, it really opened my eyes and I started to look into it a little bit more, and there's a few musicals that I think I would like to get involved in, and because I have a vehicle to do that now, I would like to do more theatre work. I just like that whole live environment, you know, very much like this, with the environment we're in right now, where you just, you know, it just happens and it is what it is. And I think to have the luxury of being able to do that is a wonderful thing.
You're what absolutely sort of fantastic.
Oh, yeah. Mandy.
Oh, Mandy and all of that, yeah.
Mandy, this show will be finished quite soon, man. If you wanted to carry on this discussion.
What sort of music would you got? I mean, obviously Chicago. What else? You know, well, I really... A bit of Old Man River, all of that?
Well, I mean, I have been known to. But I think, for me, it's just that there's one particular music called Nine. Mm. It's based on a Fellini movie called Eight and a Half, and I really like what it's all about. It's in Broadway at the moment, and Antonio Banderas is doing it at the moment, so... You know, when he finishes, maybe I'll just sneak in the door.
You've got the Latino looks there, bro. Oh, you could get away with that.
Oh, snick caps, eh?
Oh, indeed. Emma, all the way from County Tyrone, thanks for joining us, my love.
Emma.
Hello, Marti.
Hiya.
Yeah. Where I'd like to know... I'm in here.
Hey, Leah. Hello.
I'd like to know, what are your plans for this evening?
For this... Oh. I'm getting a wee bit worried now. I'll have a fluster.
Eileen's not waiting in the wings. Has she travelled with you?
No, I'm going to continue to eat all those jelly beans and then see what happens. You know what I'm going to actually do? I'm going to watch some movies tonight. I'm going to have an easy. I'm going to set my feet up and do what probably most of the nation is doing. Might even phone in the Chinese, don't know.
So it wasn't worthwhile then coming all this way?
Thank you, ladies. Yeah, we're boxing them a little bit later on. Obviously, rock and roll lifestyle aside, which, as I said, has been well documented, you do take things easy now. Do you feel like the pressure's off in some way? I know getting into Chicago was obviously a big break for you because that came off the back of a very bad times. Yeah. But do you find now that, I mean, for example, you're doing the circuit promoting your single, that you don't feel the need anymore to get involved in all of that?
Well, the darker side to what?
Well, not so much the darker side, because we know that's a sort of thing of the past, although obviously it's a daily battle. But,
yeah.
You know, you can pick and choose, well, for example, whether you appear on good
shows
like this.
I think now that I'm kind of more at ease with, you know, when I make a record, then I'm a great believer that you want to get to as many people as possible. And I understand the business a little bit more and a little bit more cooler with it, you know, whereas to say, there's no point making a record or being involved in a project and not going out and letting the world know about it, you know, and, you know, knocking on doors. That's what it's all about. You know, when you have success, the secret to having success is really that's when the hard work begins. And, you know, and I think that in some cases it should be a pleasure to be able to do it as opposed to, you know, oh no, it's going to be another mundane day. Then you know what? 9 times out of 10 it will be a mundane day. Yeah. That was quite hard to say. Bloody, that sweetie keeps coming back in.
Does it repeat on you? That's a sign of age, mate. That's indigestion. Your album, Between the Covers, when's that out, mate?
That's out next Monday.
Next Monday. Bonus DVD includes a 45-minute unseen documentary.
Oh, I've got my clothes on in it.
Oh, I was going to say, I've been broken. It was going to be a bit of bedroom footage. Ladies and gentlemen, Marti Pellow.
No, thank you.
Good to see you, mate.
Thank you.
So, Marti. Have you bought your little black dress yet?
Well, you know, what I do in the privacy of my own bedroom again, you know, I always think a little off-the-shoulder number says it all.
As long as you tan the right arm. We've all done that, ladies, haven't we? Just tanned the one and gone out. Little black dress is coming up after the break, plus psychic astrology.
Nice one.